What happens is that a lot of people who get into it, they sort of start to adopt some of the tenets of the belief system slowly. It's not all at once. So one of the things they're very concerned with, for example, they're very concerned with language. And we were talking about Orwell before the show, and he knew this. I mean, you can control people if you can control their thought, and you can control their thought if you can control language. And so one of the early things they get you to do is they redefine words like racism and sexism. So they say racism and sexism are prejudice plus power. And they say they're doing this so you can talk about structural and institutionalized racism and sexism separately from simple prejudice, what they call simply prejudice. But the outcome of doing that is that you now are saying that it's impossible to be racist towards a particular race or sexist towards a particular sex. And you're also, you're basically taking people, many, many of whom have good intent, who are in it because they're trying to end racism and sex. That's what they think they're doing. And you're telling them, well, the way to do that is to judge people and treat them differently on the basis of race and sex. Well, how do you get well-intentioned people to do that? Well, you redefine those words. So then they don't, they're not as concerned about, like, I can treat you differently, Francis, as a white man, and it won't be called, I can judge you, I can even point to your race and to your sex, and I can use slurs about, you know, I can use words like,
correct.
Yeah, I'm not going
that's
to.
That's justice.
Yeah. But I can even do those things, and I can have this race-based hatred of you, and I can have this sex-based hatred of you, and that's okay, because they've said that's not real racism, that's not real sexism.
I didn't know I was a social justice warrior.